Particularly happy to be here today. This is the first time I speak about Alexa in Luxembourg, and I work 400 meters that direction, I think. But it's awesome to be able to speak about this here. And I live in Luxembourg. I've been living here for the last 4 years. So I have the privilege of working with Alexa. I'm the lead evangelist here in Europe for Alexa, and I speak about what we call the voice revolution. I speak about what we can do with voice, the reason why we did this, but most importantly, what is the opportunity that you can leverage, you can build voice experiences for your customers and reach out your customers. So why voice? Voice is natural. Voice is what we use without thinking to speak, to communicate with others. This is how we gauge the development of new human beings, for example. This is something we've been using for a lot of time, and it's something that we use extensively, and is ours. It's unique. We don't have to think about using it. So with regards of specifically voice assistant, so we started a number of years ago, more than 5 years ago, and we launched the first Echo Alexa-enabled device made by Amazon in the US at the end of 2014. Now, since then, a lot of other devices have come across, have been developed both by Amazon and by non-Amazon. I'll tell you more about the possibility of developing Alexa-enabled devices for manufacturer, even for they're not Amazon. And we do believe in Amazon that a lot of other people seem to believe the same, that we are living the initial phases of a revolution, of a new way, of a new possibility of interacting with computers, with machines, with technology that is comparable to the way that internet or getting online information changed our lives, or the mobile revolution that changed the way that we constantly have access to all the information we want, and so on. So we are in the nascent phases of this voice user interface phase. So now it becomes usable and feasible to interact with technology, with computers, to get information, to exchange information, to do things, to command the world around us in case of a connected home, for example, with our voice. And this is now possible, and this is happening right now with all new set of opportunities. Because think about in terms of those scales, each one of those steps represented a new way to engage with your customers. New startups were born, new companies were founded, some of them are still alive, and they provide services that delight customers everywhere in the world. So this is a new set of opportunities, a new set of things that you can reap and build experiences to reach your customers with. And this is possible because the science has gone tremendously advanced in the realm of voice technology. So now it is actually possible to have a conversation with a machine, control, ask multiple questions, open-ended questions. So we are still at the beginning of this phase, but things are starting to look very, very positive for interactions, get more naturals every way. We have things that expand the realm of possibilities of communicating with a machine that is not just scripted. So very important. We're talking about here artificial intelligence, machine learning, sets that are fed, all conversations that are used to make this model better, to make this voice assistant better. And we're seeing that things as develop get easier even for developers, for brand to reach out customers in new ways. And there are also expectations here that are being developed by customers. So as I mentioned before, we started in 2014 in production with the first Echo. We since announced several different countries, specific languages for these countries. We also recently announced that sometimes in 2018 we will launch Alexa in French. In addition to that, we also make available Alexa devices in English in 80 plus countries. around the world. Luxembourg is one of them. And this is something we started in 2018. Now we can buy international versions of these devices in 80 plus countries. So the reach starts to get there, the critical mass that enables you to create these voice experiences here in Luxembourg or anywhere else in the world to reach where you choose, where your customers are. So this is particularly important because you can create a voice, an engaging voice experiences. You create what we call a skill, which is a voice first equivalent of an app, and then you distribute it where you want in the markets that you want. Now, I'll give you some numbers and I also will give you some a personal experience. So I'll start with the personal experience. In our house, we have three kids and we started using Echo devices with them more than 2 years ago. When they started using these devices, they didn't wonder where was the voice coming from, what's behind it. They just figure out very quickly what's in it for me, and they make it happen. They started asking about music, the jokes that they wanted, the information that they wanted, being silly, but that worked for them perfectly. And our kids, as well as there's a whole generation out there that is growing up thinking that it's perfectly fine and it's perfectly natural to talk with technology to get things done. So think about this in terms. So this is the anecdotal part that should tell you that this is inevitable, this is happening. Now, if you prefer to have a hard numbers, there is some numbers here as well that we can that I can share with you. There is several usage that we see in houses, in offices, in cars. They deal with music, getting entertainment, getting information, getting to control connected device in a smart home setting, for example. But there is a trade union in this. These are all things that do something for a user. These are not pitches, for example. This is not product pushes or standard or traditional marketing or advertisement. These are experiences that users and customers do enjoy because they do something for them, so very important. And another important point here that I wanted to show you is that Alexa, in houses with more than one person, in 80% of the cases, used by multiple people. So if you think about the ramification of that, we're thinking about a device that is not the usage or reserve or reservation of one person in the house, perhaps the more technical inclined. No, the opposite. 80% of the cases, this becomes a staple in conversations, in the way that technology is used inside a whole family. Very important. Now, with regards of the way that we make this available for you or for developers around the world, and by developer, I mean anybody that develops voice experiences on Alexa, there is these two frameworks. One is called the Alexa Skills Kit. This is how you add new features to Alexa. So, as I said before, a skill is a voice-first equivalent of an app. So you create these apps. It could be Starbucks, it could be Uber, it could be Domino's Pizza, anything you use or you might be using in a different channel. You enable it, and you can ask Alexa, Alexa, enable Uber, and you start using it. So this is the way that this concept works. Now, the other side, it's called the Alexa Voice Service, which is a framework, a set of tools that we made available to build Alexa into your products. Let's say you're a manufacturer of anything that has a speaker, a microphone, and a connection. You can embed Alexa in it to add the voice assistant to what your device does. Because the concept is basically here to have Alexa anywhere in the house, in an office, as I say, in a car, in an ambient. The idea here is that you move away from the concept of speaking into a device. Because if you think about it, that's still something that reduces a little bit the naturality of it. The more natural this whole experience is, the more delightful, the less friction, and the more usage. So within this concept, putting Alexa everywhere makes it possible to just speak with an ambient. Because one of the visions behind Alexa was exactly that, to enable, some of you may know, be familiar with the Star Trek computer. That concept, you just walk into a room, into the deck of the enterprise, you just speak with this computing entity that that knows, that serves you, and but you don't speak into a specific device, you just speak around. So it becomes very powerful in that case because the experience feels like you're speaking with your own house. So that is the idea. That's why we have opened up the possibility of creating and putting Alexa into these devices. And we've seen a number of form factors. Right now, there is more than 50 form factors of Alexa-enabled devices for a total of about 4,000 products, so made by third parties. And you can see here that there is a number of different usage from robots to lights. The big round you see in the back, that's a GE light. So it's a light that provides obviously different tones, different ways of leveling to access that service, which is light, but additionally provides also an entry point, an endpoint in this case, for an Alexa. So Alexa can be interacted with through this light. Same concept. Because at the end of the day, what we think in Amazon is that why should you not make available to a customer a scenario in which, for example, you take your coffee in the morning in the kitchen and you speak and you consume your news or your information or what you have to do for the day from a screen that is placed on your wall, on your fridge, or any other appliance, or anywhere else in the house. So the idea is that you leverage the voice that we always carry with ourselves just to get things done around us. Now, From a skills point of view, we have more than 40,000 already developed in the world. Some of the brands you might recognize from these screens. I wanted to show you some of the reasons why you should buy, why you should build a skill. Maybe you have something to sell. Maybe you have something to promote. Maybe you have to serve your customers, all customers, premium customers, and so on. Or maybe you want to monetize from an idea. These are all good reasons to do it. Just to see a couple of them, you see here, for example, Dunkirk. Dunkirk was a war movie, a World War II movie from last season that was promoted, amongst other ways, with a voice game. So this voice game that didn't say, hey, go and watch Dunkirk because it's good. No, didn't do anything of that. It provided a game that brought the players on the beach in Dunkirk and then made an experience, a vocal gamified experience that was part of the marketing campaigns of the company. So pretty powerful. Or something else here, we have Tide. So Tide makes detergents, a number of products that deals with the cleaning, with stain removal. And they developed something that increased their brand affinity, not by pitching their product, but by resolving a problem. So they created experiences, vocal experiences. So you can ask Alexa, Alexa ask Tide, how do I remove this wine stain from my shirt? And then so you get something done. And that's how you create this brand affinity. So that the user knows at that point that Tide had just done something for them. And that's the way you do, you leverage these voice experiences and so on. As I mentioned before, kids super popular with the Echo is extremely popular with them. It's natural; they click right away. At least that was my direct experience of the people that I spoke with. And we added something called in Alexa the gadgets API. This is an API that leverages possibility of connecting devices. In this case, you see here; these are buttons. Think about a game like Trivial Pursuit or Summon Says that now has become Summon Tap. You do things, there is voice games, and you can leverage all of these experiences by programming these connected devices. And the buttons are just the first example of this connected device. Now, looking ahead, we're always expanding, looking to expand, to serve, to reach more customers in their languages or in English, for example, and adding more features all the time. We release a lot of new features. Just yesterday, we announced that now we have monetization programs that have become general availability in the US. So you now can have in-skill transactions, in-skill purchases. That opens up on a whole new world on ways to monetize and to reach and to actually get monetization and rewards from your voice experience, the one you developed. Obviously, there is a lot more of this, and I could talk for a very long time about these specific topics. I thank you very much for your attention. I hope I've inspired you to look up more. Thank you very much. Have a great day.